Good morning, guys. Jerry Hawk 250 here. I'm getting ready to do some performance mods on my Venom X22R 250. I have a Wisco 11-to-1 piston I'm gonna install. This is actually for a CRF 230F engine. So they're supposed to be compatible, so I'm gonna find out shortly. And then also have a stage one hot cam for the CRF 150F, which is the same cams for either bike. This should give me more mid-range and high RPM performance, and shouldn't hurt the low end because I'm increased compression ratio. Now this is 11-to-1 compression rate piston, but with the stock gasket, I'm not sure exactly what it is. I think it's around 10.5-to-1 compression. Now if I separate this gasket, it's three layers. They say you can use one side of the gasket as a thin gasket, and that'll actually push it up to 11-to-1 compression. And of course it's the base gasket. And then I printed out my CRF 230F service manual. So I'll make sure I'm getting everything to spec, you know, gap the whole bit. I'll also be pulling the head and porting it later after I put the piston and cam in. That'll probably take the longest, the cam and piston swap. That's going to be pretty quick. Now, the big thing is, will I be able to remove the head and cylinder without removing the engine from the bike? We'll find out.
I already checked to make sure I have the engine at top dead center, and as you see, these lines line up with the bottom of the valve cover cap. Let's see if I can get this removed. Before it goes flying around. valve cover off, no problem. I have to remove the starter so I can remove the actual cam pinchner. Get that removed. Move this cam tensioner out. And a chain tensioner. Good old impact. Get that back on top dead center. This bolt. Kind of drop it down in the engine. Stop cam. There we go. That bolt. This should be 10 millimeter. Moment of truth, see if I can get this off without removing the engine. Nope. So, on to plan B, I will have to remove the whole engine.
Okay, so I was able to just unbolt the engine from the frame, just let it sit down the bottom of the frame, kind of tilt it, and get up. So I don't really have to pick it up and remove it from the bike itself. I admit unhooking wires, which I already had started doing, and I realized I didn't even need to do that. So, sorry I got the head off. Sorry I missed filming that. No big deal there. Next would be to pull a cylinder off, piston. Got a little carbon billet on top. Same thing to head, it's got a little carbon, but I'm going to be cleaning that all up anyhow. Bike just has a little 1400 miles on it. Looking at the head, I mean, intake side is definitely needs to be cleaned up some. Do a little port matching. Exhaust side, yes. Yeah, about like my Hawk head, it's got a lot of cleaning up to do too. I'll get to that after I change the piston out. Thank you.
got that out, one of the first things we want to do is put a rag around this hole so that we don't drop anything in there. Cylinder still looks pretty, but I still don't have to pass a hone through it. So when I put the new rings, piston rings, that they will seat. Nice clean rag around there. Stuff around that hole. I need to get me some needle nose. Piston out. Now you notice on here, you go by the manual, you know, there's an end on the intake side. On the new piston, there's an arrow pointing towards the exhaust, so that would be a little confusing, so you got to watch out for that. So let's see, make sure these are the same. Okay, we're the same thing, just a matter of how you, they're close, very, very close. We're good. Wash it out real good, some soap water. Make sure to clean this out real good. And I'll oil it down right before I put it on the back on the motor. Oh yeah, looks good inside. Alright, checking the gap in the ring. That is dead on. second ring. Use the piston to get it to sit down square. And that one should be 65. That one's a little snug. I'm gonna have to file it. And oil. It should be about 9 millimeters. That one a little bit too. What works out perfect is I got this gasket on here, which lines up perfectly with my intake. So I can use that as a guideline. I'll scribe around here and then start removing a little material.
you see, I took a good bit out of the exhaust side. Just got to polish it up a little bit. Intake side. Yep, just gotta finish polishing it up and I'm done with that, and I can reinstall. Alright, so I got it all back together. It's fired right up. I went to take a little short ride. Yeah, it definitely has a little more low end for sure. And mid and an upper range. I didn't go wide open throttle, but definitely got some more power to it. And like I said, I went with a thick gasket, the standard thick gasket on the head. So it's really only about 10.5 to 1. But I may put the thin gasket later on after after that engine actually breaks in. But yeah, it is definitely worth the effort. Get it a little crankier. Exhaust. So yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe. Jerry Hawk 250 signing off.